Go! Capcom, we're go for landing.
Roger, understand. Go for landing. 3,000 feet.
You knew that decisions were made in this place. You had a sense of history.
Verify that both S-band breakers are in. Over.
It was a workplace, a home, a sanctuary, where a team of doers made the impossible happen.
Capcom, we're stay for T1.
Where farm boys, fresh grads, and some who claim they were just plain lucky made history here in Houston and out of this world.
Engine arm off.
We copy you down, Eagle.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
This is Mission Control.
I look at it as a leadership laboratory where we take young people in there. Green is grass, fresh out of college. And we turn men and women into controllers.
Okay, all flight controllers, gonna go for landing. Retro.
Go.
Righto.
Go.
Guidance.
Go.
Control.
Go.
The young men in skinny ties and pocket protectors, with just a few years under their belts, found themselves facing the presidential challenge of the decade.
Landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth.
At the helm of that landing was none other than Flight Director Gene Kranz, a former aerospace engineer and fighter pilot.
My final words to my controllers were, I will stand behind every decision you will make. We came into this room as a team, and we will leave as a team. And then one of my controllers went and locked the control room doors, and we would not leave that room, and the doors would not be open until we'd either landed, we'd crashed, or we aborted. And only one of those cases was good. We had to land.
Following in the footsteps of former flight director Chris Kraft, Kranz's renowned mantra of tough and competent became the team's working creed.
How's our margin looking, Bob?
Failure was not an option.
The managers gave us that responsibility. They trusted us. And when somebody trusts you that much, you're damn sure not going to let them down.
Jerry Bostick, a flight dynamics or FIDO controller from rural Mississippi, sat in what was known as the trench, the very frontier, seating the guys who walked with a bit of swagger. They knew their job was to guide the spacecraft. In the retro seat right next to him was Chuck Dietrich.
We were all young at the time, and we weren't smart enough to be scared or think we couldn't do it.
Steely-eyed missile man John Aaron, the son of a farmer and minister, was an ECOM controller, monitoring electrical and environmental life support systems.
We had a lot of early failures. We blew up a lot of stuff. But we always learn something.
A place of discovery, endeared with coffee stains and tar-sooted ceilings.
We smoked cigarettes, pipes, you know, cigars in that room right on down the line. But that was the nature of the beast.
But the Mission Operation Control Room, or MOCR 2, was just one of several that made up the center. In the Support Services, or SSR room, you found then ECOM trainee Mississippi native Bill Moon, the first Asian American to work in Mission Control.
There's a sense of rivalry amongst the organizations. You know, we were the systems guys. And then you had the trench that were the FIDOs and GIDOs and retros. I mean, they showed us how to get there. You know, they pointed, looked at the stars and all that. I don't understand all that good stuff. But we kept the vehicles running, you know, and kept the crew alive.
That crew was a trio, some of the best and brightest. Commander Neil Armstrong, Lunar Module Pilot Edwin Buzz Aldrin, and Command Module Pilot Michael Collins.
Mike Collins was probably the brightest of the three. Well-read, had a hell of a education, everything like that.
Frank Hughes knew them like family. It was his job. As a simulator instructor, he trained the astronauts how to troubleshoot if things went wrong.
Let's face it, they didn't know, we don't know. We all learned together.
On July 16, 1969, Hughes would also find himself in Mission Control, along with Ed Findell, a controller tasked to support communications with Michael Collins. Years later, Findell would be known as Captain Video for his camera work with the Lunar Rover.
You just went and did things. Your boss said to do it. You found a way to do it.
The right kind of attitude for the right kind of mission. Findell's colleague Rod Lowe knew they were on the verge of doing something big when he introduced his six-year-old son to Neil Armstrong.
I asked Greg, I said, do you know who that was? He said, no, he didn't have the idea. And I said, we're going to make him the first man on the moon.
And that's exactly what they did.
That's one small step for man.
In this very room. This young team of professionals would begin the mission of a lifetime.
No doubt it's going to work. We're going to make it happen.
landing man on the moon and returning him safely to Earth.
There's no equivocation. It's go or no go.